So good morning, friends. So today we are planning to discuss about wage rate determination, competitive and non-competitive labor market. It is one of the important topic in EdExcel IAL Economics Unit 3. So most of the students are feeling very difficult while dealing with the labor market MCQ. So this video will help to get some idea about how to deal with labor market MCQ. So first question we are discussing about which calculation would give the marginal revenue product of labor for a firm selling its product in an imperfectly competitive product market. So the question is, how we are going to calculate the marginal revenue product? That is a basic for demand for labor, how much employees a particular employer will employ. Why? Because based on the marginal revenue product. How to calculate the marginal revenue product? That is the question. Actually, if you know the formula of calculating marginal revenue product mix, you can answer this question very easily. Okay, let's check the options. Option A, the average output produced per worker employed into marginal revenue of the product. Option B, the average output produced per worker employed into price of the product. Option C, the extra product produced by an additional worker into marginal revenue of the product. Option D, the extra product produced by an additional worker into price of the product. Actually, first two options, that is option A and option B, is wrong because they are using average output produced by per worker employed. And first option, if you check option A, average output into marginal revenue product. Actually, average output came, that's why it is wrong. Second option, average output and price of the product. So that is wrong. Why? Because how we are calculating the marginal revenue product, that is the formula is there, the marginal physical product, that is an extra product produced by an additional worker, into the marginal revenue of the product, the extra revenue gained in the particular firm from that particular employer. That is called what? Marginal revenue product. So now you guys know the answer. Option C is the right answer. The extra product produced by an additional worker into the marginal revenue product. Why option D is wrong is that the extra product produced by additional worker, that is a marginal revenue product, into price of the product. Now that is the problem. Not a price of the product, the additional revenue you are gaining from the sale of the particular output produced by an employee. So that is called what? Marginal revenue product. Marginal revenue product means the extra product produced by an additional worker, or will be say marginal physical product into marginal revenue of the product. That is what? Marginal revenue product. So option C is the right answer. So once again, which calculation would give you marginal revenue product of a labor of the firm selling its product in an imperfectly competitive product? You can see that the extra product produced by an additional worker into marginal revenue product. So second question, the diagram illustrates the monopsony labor market, which the government has imposed a national minimum wage. So that's what they said, that the diagram illustrates the monopsony labor market in which the government has imposed a minimum wage. What was the difference between the wage the monopsonist wished to pay and the wage received by the labor? So you know that monopsony labor market, this is a marginal cost and this is a supply of labor, and this is the wage rate. We can say that marginal cost is equal to marginal revenue product is this point. At this point, they will pay. Normally, if you go for demand and supply wage rate, means you say this is the equilibrium wage rate, because this is supply of labor and marginal revenue product, that's the demand for labor, and this is the equilibrium wage rate. Because of this monopsony labor market, so their additional cost of employing additional labor is very high. So that's why supply and marginal cost are different. So marginal cost is equal to marginal revenue at this point. At this point, this is the supply of labor, so they will charge which wage rate? W1. Why? Because they are having a buying power. It is a monopsony, so it's a single buyer, so they have a buying power. So they used to be charged only which wage rate? A wage rate which is below the equilibrium rate. That is OW1 is the wage rate applicable for, they will charge in their monopsony labor market. The question is that what was the difference between wage that monopsonist wish to pay, that is how much OW1, and the wage received by the labor. When the government imposes a national minimum wage, the wage rate is how much OW2. But monopsonist is paying how much only OW1. So the difference between these two is what? That's the question. So you can see option A, W1 and W3. W1, that means OW1 and W3. This is the difference? No. So option A is wrong. Then W1 and W2, yes, this is the difference, isn't it? This is the previous wage, monopsonist wage, they used to pay by W1. But now the worker is getting how much? OW2. So the difference is W1 and W2. So that is the difference. So option B is the right answer. If you check option C, that is wrong, because it is a difference between W2 is the minimum wage and this is not the monopsony wage. So that's why. Then W2 and W4, that is actually maximum wage. So in this case, we will say that this option is B is the right one, isn't it? So in this question, the government introduces a minimum wage above the equilibrium market wage rate. How will this affect the low-paid workers according to the marginal revenue product theory? Actually, according to the marginal revenue product theory, the wage rate is based on the marginal revenue product. That means how much additional revenue created by an additional employer, that is the marginal revenue, isn't it? How much output they based on that? We already know in the first question we discussed how marginal revenue product is created. So it is a marginal physical product into the marginal revenue of the physical product or marginal revenue product. So first option, all those initially in employment will receive the new guaranteed minimum wage. That option is wrong. Okay. How it will affect the low paid workers only. So that is, we don't know all those who initially employed are low paid or not. That's why that particular option is wrong. Fewer of these are not already in employment will enter the labor force. When the national minimum wage is introduced, fewer of those not already in employment will enter the labor force. Actually, if they wish to enter the labor force even, the employment won't be there. So question is that how this will affect the low paid workers. So that option is wrong. There will be an increase in the number of low paid workers in employment. That won't happen. Why? Because the producer now is not motivated to employ more people because wage rate is very high. So option D, some low paid workers will lose their job. Yes, option D is the right answer, because some low paid workers will lose their job. So the next question, the diagram shows the effect of introduction of national minimum wage, that is WM, in an occupation where workers are employed by a profit-maximizing monopsonist. What would happen to the total wages received by the workers in the occupation? So question is that when the government is introducing a national minimum wage, that is WM, in the occupation where workers are employed in a profit-maximizing monopsonist. They are the monopsonist. So we know that in previous question also we discussed about the monopsonist. So here we can see that monopsonist will employ the point at which MC is equal to marginal revenue product of the labor. At that point, this is the wage rate they will charge, that is how much OW1 or W1. OW1 is the wage rate. And the question is that what happened to the total wage received by the workers in the operation? So total wage is number of workers. This is the quantity. Now OQ1, that is the quantity of that is much people are employed into wage rate OW1. So this entire rectangle will be considered as the total wage cost. The question is that when the government introduces a national minimum wage, what will be the total wage cost? This is the national minimum wage, isn't it? OW1. So from here, they are charging at the wage here, right? At the point at which this is a supply of labor, so here will be the employment. So the total wage cost will increase from OWM into we will say the price into quantity means OQ. So length into breadth is the total area. So total area means this OWM UQ3. So what happened to the total wages received by the workers in the occupation? So we can see that option A, they decreased from OW2 to OVQ2. Listen, OW2, this wage to VQ2. Actually, that is an equilibrium wage. Actually, in monopsonist wage rate is this one only. But this wage rate is showing what equilibrium wage rate. That's why that is wrong. They decrease from OW to ZQ. That is actually something else, not about this one. That is also come under the equilibrium wage rate line only. So that option is also wrong. They increase from OWX to 1. Yeah, very good. That portion is correct. To OWM. Yeah, that is also correct. YQ1. Yeah, that is wrong actually. OWM UQ3. So option D is the right answer. It is increased from OW1XQ1 to OWM UQ3. So you can see that this was a previously total wage rate, and now the total wage rate is OW to VQ2. So this entire portion is the wage cost is increased. So option D is the right answer. So next question. A firm operate under the perfect competition in both product and factor market, with the labor is the only variable factor input. In the diagram, the line JK shows the relationship between marginal physical product and labor and the hours worked. So there is a diagram that shows the marginal physical product and the number of labors. When the marginal revenue product is $1.6, the firm uses 3,000 of the labor. What was the hourly wage rate? So that is a very simple question. So what is the wage rate? Wage rate, I told you, you consider based on the marginal revenue product, isn't it? So how to calculate the marginal revenue product in the first question itself, I told you that how to calculate the marginal physical product into marginal revenue, isn't it? So 3,000 employee means the marginal physical product you have to calculate. Marginal physical product is how much? 4. So here they given the marginal revenue product. So 4 into 1.60. That is, I think it is option D. It is 6.40. It is $6.40. That is the hourly wage rate. So it is a very simple question. If you know how to calculate the marginal physical product, the formula, marginal revenue product, so it will be easy to calculate. It is very simple. If you check the calculation, you can able to say that 1.60 multiplied by 4. Then you will be get what? That is a marginal revenue product into marginal physical product. At 3,000 employees, marginal physical product is how much? It is 4. So this is, so option D is the right answer. That is 6.40.